Hello everyone, I, Kundan Chandrakar, welcome you all to the SWAYAM online course on controlling risk in demolition work. Now coming today's lecture, in this video we are going to learn about various safety and control measures in demolition work. Here are the contents we will cover in this video. The first is the demolition hazards and control measures. Second is a thing to know before starting the demolition. Demolition advantage and demolition disadvantage, and the last is the conclusion part. Let us discuss briefly about the first point, is that demolition hazards and control measures. Demolition work involves many of the same hazards that arise during other construction activity. Still, it includes additional hazards due to unknown factors such as changes to the building structure over time, hidden material, or inappropriate method used during original construction. Here are the 16 common hazards during demolition and their corresponding control measures. The first is the fall from height. Fall from height are the risk in demolition activity, presenting one of the most recurrent hazards because worker frequently instead with tall structure and contend with unstable surface. This accident can result in serious injuries or in many cases prove fatal. To prevent such occurrence, it is crucial that extensive measures are put into place. One of the primary steps involve equipping worker with appropriate fall protection gear. This gear typically consists of harness and lanyard design to arrest fall by securing the wiring to the solid anchoring point, mitigating the potential for free fall. These safety measures ensure that worker remain attached to the structure even if they lose balance, significantly reducing the risk of fall related injuries or fatalities. The second important point is a falling debris. Falling debris is that significant risk during the demolition operation, as dislodged piece of the structure can fall unprotectively and inflamed serve to the harm on workers. This danger is particularly acute when heavy material or sharp objects are involved. To mitigate this risk, addressing to the proper safety protection is essentially protection. Personal protection equipment including hard hats and safety glasses is necessary to safeguard worker from injuries. Additionally, implementing protection measures around the site such as debris, netting or catch platform can minimize the danger by containing or deliberating or diverting falling object. This net or platform absorb the energy of falling debris, halting their descents of thus protection those on the ground level. However, regular inspection and maintenance of this protective installation and critical to ensure their effectiveness throughout demolition. Let's talk about the another main point, is that premature collapse of structure. The premature collapse of structure during demolition is a serve hazards that can lead to catastrophic accident, potentially causing injury or death to the worker and bystander. This may occur due to improper planning, sequence of demolition, or inadequate support to the structure during the process. Insufficient knowledge about the building structure or unexpected alterations can also lead to premature collapse. To mitigate this risk, detailed surveying and planning are crucial. Every step of demolition must be careful to maintain structure stability. Further, more temporary supports or bracing system may be installed to reinforce the structure during the demolition. Addressing to local regulation and safety guidelines and consulting with structure engineer can also be instrumental in preventing premature collapses. Another vital safety measures in regularly monitor the demolition process to identify the rectify any potential stability issues. The fourth important point, that is dust and fumes. Dust and fumes pose significant hazards during demolition activity, potentially leading to respiratory complications and visibility issues. When a structure is demolished, various material can be pulverized, release microscopic particles into the air. This can contain harmful substances such as silica, asbestos and other toxic depending on the material used in building. Further, more the use of contained demolition equipment can produce dangerous exhaust fumes. To mitigate this risk, dust suspension method like water spray or mistling system can be used to reduce airborne particles. For fumes, proper ventilation is crucial, especially in enclosed space. Workers should also wear appropriate respirator protection equipment to prevent inhalation of harmful particles or gases. Additionally, regular air quality monitor can help ensure the effectiveness of these control measures and enable timely adjustment if needed. Let us discuss the fifth important topic, are the silting up of drainage system by dust. One of the lesser known hazards associated with demolition work is that silting up of drainage system by dust. When worker demolished a structure, the dust can get into the drainage system and clog it up. This can cause serious flooding problem if the drainage system is not cleared out of timely manner. To avoid this, it is important to aware of the hazards and take the necessary precautions to prevent dust from entering the drainage system. This includes using proper ventilation and keep the area around the drainage system clear the debris. The next important point is that the problem arises from spilled fuel oil. Spilled fuel oil during demolition work pose serious safety and environmental risk. Such spill can potentially ignite, leading to fire or even explosive, particularly if they come into contact with hot surface or electrical equipment. Additionally, spill can lead to soil and water contamination, posing environmental hazards and potential legal implication. Strict protocol must be followed to prevent such issue when handling fuel oil. Firstly, machinery should be regularly inspected for leaks and properly maintained. The area around fuel tank and machinery should be kept and clean and debris free to reduce the chances of accident ignition. Furthermore, appropriate contaminant method should be used during fuel storage transporting to avoid spills. This method could include secondary contaminant system such as drip tray and spill having emergency response plan. Including spill kits and fire extinguisher can help to manage situation swiftly and effectively. Let us discuss the manual handling point. Manual handling involves the moving, lifting, carry, pushing the object. Present another common hazards during demolition activities, worker may be required to handle heavy or evacuate material and heavy or evacuate material, potentially leading to physical injuries including disordered strain, sprain and even more serious injuries if the worker trips or fall while handling an item. To mitigate this risk, employer should endeavor to minimize the need of manual handling by using mechanical aids such as forklifts or cranes. When manual handling is unavoidable, training is critical to ensure worker know the correct lifting technique and understand the risk. The use of personal protective equipment such as gloves and safety footwear can also help reduce injury. Let us discuss the 8th important point, is that asbestos and other hazardous substance. Another hazard to be aware of the presence of asbestos and other hazardous substance. Many older buildings contain asbestos which can release harmful fibers into the air. If disturbed, many building material may also contain other hazard substance such as lead. To protect yourself from asbestos and other hazardous substance, it is important to wear proper personal protective equipment such as respiratory system. Additionally, you should try to work well ventilation area to avoid inhale harmful fibers. If you suspect that the building contains asbestos or other hazardous substance, you should have to inspect by a qualified professionals before starting any demolition work. Let us talk about the ninth important point, is that noise and vibrations. Another hazards associated with demolition is that noise and vibrations from heavy plant and equipment. The machinery used in demolition work can be very loud, and it vibrating can harm your health. To protect yourself from noise and vibration, it is important to wear proper hearing protection such as earplugs or ear mug. Additionally, you should try to work in a well ventilation area to reduce the noise level. If the noise level is too loud, you may need to use the sound blocking ear mugs and ear plug. The last important point is that electrical shocks. One of the most serious hazard associated with demolition work is electrical shocks. This can occur when worker come into contact with live electrical wire or equipment. Electrical shock can lead to serious injury or even death. So, it's important to take the necessary precautions to avoid it. Some way you can do this include de-energized electrical equipment before working on it, wearing proper personal protective equipment, and avoiding area with water and dampness. You should also be cautious when working near electrical wire or equipment. If you are unsure how to safely work with electricity, you would consult a qualified electrician. Let us discuss the another main important point, that is fire and explosion. Another hazard associated with demolition is fire and explosion from flammable and explosive substance. Many chemical and gases used in demolition are highly flammable and can easily catch fire or explode fire if improper handled. To protect yourself from fire and explosion, it is important to be aware of the hazards of the substance you use and take the necessary precautions. You can do this by reading the labels on the contents, label on all containers, keeping flammable substance away from heat or flames, and using proper ventilation when working with volatile substance. Additionally, you should have a fire extinguisher handy in an emergency. The next point is the smoke from burning waste. Another hazard associated with demolition is smoke from burning waste, timber and material. When demolition work is being done, a lot of waste timber and material are often burnt. This can release harmful toxic into the air, harming your health. Wearing a respirator or face mask is important to protect yourself from smoke. Additionally, you should work in a well ventilation area to avoid inhale harmful toxin. If the smoke is too dense, you may need to leave the area and seek fresh air. Let us discuss the another point, is a pneumatically drill and power tool. Another hazard associated with demolition work is pneumatically drill and power tool. This tool can generate a lot of noise and vibration, harming your health. They can also create dust and flying debris, which can be dangerous if inhaled. To protect yourself from pneumatically drill and power tool, it is important to wear proper hearing protection such as earplug and ear muff. Additionally, you should wear a dust mask or respirator to avoid inhaling harmful particle. Additionally, you should try to work in well ventilation area to reduce the risk of exposure to harmful toxins. Let us discuss the another main important point, is that the existence of services. Another hazard associated with demolition work is the existence of service such as electricity, gas and water mains. This service can be damaged during demolition, leading to serious injury or death. To protect yourself from hazards, It's important to aware the locations of all service before starting work. Additionally, you should always call the utility company to have the service disconnected before starting work. Additionally, you should never try to disconnect the service yourself. Let's talk about the another point is that collision with heavy plant or machinery. Another hazard associated with demolition is colliding with heavy plant and machinery. Demolition work often involve the use of large piece of machinery such as excavators and bulldozers. If you are not careful, you could easily be hit by one of these machines. To protect yourself from the hazards, it's important to be aware of the location of all plants and machinery at all times. You should never walk in front of the behind of moving machine. Additionally, you should always wear bright clothing to be more visible to the machinery operations. Let us discuss the another point is that plant and vehicle overturn. Another hazard associated with demolition work is plant and vehicle overturning. This can happen if the plant and vehicle is not properly secured or the ground is too soft. If the plant or vehicle overturned, it can cause serious injury or death. To protect yourself from these hazards, it is important to be aware of the location of all plants and vehicle at all times. Additionally, you should never walk under the around of the plant and the vehicle. These are being lifted. Additionally, you should always wear bright clothes and to more visible to the machinery operations. Let us discuss the another main important point, that is thing to know before starting the demolition work. Before any work is started, the full site investigation will help to determine the potential hazards and risk associated with the demolition work. This will help to ensure the safety of the workers and the public. The investigation should cover the following topics. The first is a before beginning demolitions. It is important to investigate the construction detail of the building that will be decomplished and of any neighboring structures. This will help ensure the demolition is carried out safely and without damaging nearby building. The next point is that the any hazardous material present such as asbestos or lead, this is important to ensure the safety of those doing the demolition and avoid spreading any hazardous material. The location of any underground and overhead services, water, electricity and gas, etc. The investigations, the area of underground cellar, storage tank and bunkers is important. This is especially important if flammable or explosive substance were previously stored in this area. This will help to avoid any accidents or damage during the demolition process. The next point, it is important to investigation the location of any public throughout piers adjacent to the structure of building. This will help to ensure the work can be carried out safely and without disturbing the surrounding area. This type of foundations, the building is built on slab, footing, etc. This is important as it will affect how the demolition is carried out. For example, a building with a footing foundation must have a foundation excavation before the demolition can begin. The next point, the height of the building, for example, a tall building will need to be demolished from the top down, while the shorter building can be demolished from the bottom up. Let us discuss the advantage and disadvantage of demolitions. Demolition, the process of intentionally tearing down and dismantling a structure, offer both advantage and disadvantage. The choice of demolished a building or a structure should be carefully considered, taking into account various factors. Here are the overview of the advantage and disadvantage of demolition. The first one is the advantage of demolition, space utilization. Demolition outdated or structure allow for the efficient use of land and space. New or more functional building or develop can be constructed in their place. Second point is the safety improvement. Removing structurally unsound and hazardous building enhance safety for occupants, neighboring properties and the community. The third point is the environmental upgrades. Demolition can create an opportunity to remediate contaminated sites, remove asbestos or lead based material and improve environmental conditions. The next point is a renovation and remodeling. Demolition enables property owner to remodel or renovate existing structure to meet modern needs and standards. The next point is the economic development. Demolition can pave the way of economic growth and development by attracting new business and investment to an area. The next point is an infrastructure project. Demolition is often necessary for the construction of infrastructure projects like highways, bridges and tunnels. The next point is a safety and security. Demolishing abandoned or building can improve neighboring safety and security by eliminating potential haven for criminal activities. Let us talk about disadvantage of demolition. The first point is an environmental impact. Demolition can generate significant waste including hazardous material which may neglecting impact the hazardous impact the environmental if not managed properly. The second point is a resource consumption. Demolition consumes energy and resource particularly in the disposal or debris and material. The third point is a historical and cultural losses. Demolition can result in the loss of historical or cultural significant structure, erasing valuable heritage. The next point is a community disruption. Demolition activity such as noise, dust and traffic disruption can inconvenience and disturb neighbor communication. The next point is a health hazard. The presence of hazardous material like asbestos or lead can pose health risk and worker and the public if not handled correctly. The next point is cost. Demolition can be expensive due to labor, equipment, disposal fees and unprocessed challenges. The next point is a negative perceptions. Demolition can sometimes be seen as wasteful and destructive, leading to negative public perceptions and potential communication resistance. The next point is a regulatory hurdles. Obtain permits and complying with regulations for demolition can be time consuming and complex. The next point is the unforeseen challenges. Unexpected structural issues or environmental complications may arise during demolition, leading to delay and increases cost. In summary, demolition offers several advantages such as space utilization, safety improvement, and economic development. However, it also comes with disadvantages including environmental impact, resource consumption, and potential culture and historical losses. Decision regarding demolition should consider this factor and the made in alignment with the goal and need to community and the environment. Sustainability and responsible demolition practices, including recycle and proper waste management, can help mitigate some of the disadvantage associated with demolitions. Let us discuss the last important point is that conclusion. The demolition industry presents numerous hazards that require diligent management and effective control measures. We can create a safer work environment by prioritizing safety protocols, such as providing appropriate protective gear, maintaining structural stability, addressing dust and fume exposure, and minimize manual handling risk. Additionally, being the aware of hazardous material, managing noise and vibrations, and taking precaution against electrical hazards, fire and service are crucial for worker safety. Through this measure can be mitigate risk, minimize accident and foster a safety culture in the construction industry. With this, we will end our today's lecture here. Thank you for your patience. We will meet in our next lecture. Thank you.